Hey, this is Ben at Ben's Carts, and now we have the hotdogcartstore.com, which is mobile friendly and easier to operate. So be sure to check that out. I wanted to start something a little different. I'm going to take emails selected each day or each week that I feel would help the most people and answer those to the best of my ability. Obviously, we have the show each month, but where you can call in and ask questions, but sometimes I get some really good emails that, even though we've covered a lot of the aspects of the questions in the emails, I can help narrow that down for you and hopefully help get you on your way. Hey, this one comes at a great time. It comes from Nome. He's in Canada, Edmonton, Canada, and we are facing winter, and sometimes vendors don't work in the winter. Some do work through the winter. We have vendors in Canada that work all year round, and in Alaska that work all year round, and now we've got vendors from Romania to the Ukraine who work even those cold winters. So to get started here, this is from Nome, and I thank Nome for submitting this. It says he's opening a cart in a frozen wasteland. He says, "Hey, Ben, I'm from Nome, from Edmonton, Canada. I wanted to say how grateful I am, thankful for your videos. You're very welcome. I discovered your videos just 4 days ago and watched almost all of them. I doubt it. He probably doesn't realize there's over 200. I became a big fan. I'm very eager to start my own hot dog cart and already met my city and local health department executives. I read pretty much all the rules and regulations I could find. One thing still quite discourages me. Let's see, that is Field Marshal Winter. Yep, winter is coming, bad timing, and our once lively and busy streets and parks will soon become a frozen wasteland. Now, the winter we are expecting should be mild, but then again, a mild winter in northern Canada is still colder than a freaking freezing winter in Minneapolis. If I'm to get my business going, I should give it an extra prep, buying a 10x10 plastic canopy," which we cover this. If you go to learnhotdogs.com and type in winter, we talk about the different ways you can prepare and work in the winter. But buying a 10x10 plastic canopy and a tornado heater or a torpedo heater. At first, I thought of vending near my local university with 40,000 students and some really crappy food. A hot dog cart would be a blast, he says, but they would not let me near there, at least not 1,200 feet away. I want to stop you right there, Nome, and find out what does that mean? They won't let you. Last I checked, Canada is much like the U.S., and you have Bill of Rights and a constitution and that allows you to open a legal business. I don't understand this 1,200 feet away thing. Unless they're protecting other businesses. If that's the case, that would be illegal and that violates your civil rights. I would look into that. I'd find out who made that rule. Where did that rule come from? Does it really exist? Or did somebody just tell you this? I have a great article that will help you with that. If you go to learnhotdogs.com/liar, that will cover that. My second option is going on a street corner, but it seems impossible to find a sidewalk wide enough to get approved for a 10x10 tent, which I can understand, and still have good enough foot traffic. I do want to bring up something. My wife and I traveled a few years ago to Illinois during a brutal winter and watched a 73-year-old man vend. He's got three or four of my carts now, and he has had a he worked in the brutal winter. I was there and worked with him. And he does work at night for the college kids, and he has the torpedo heaters and no canopy. So probably doable still, without the 10x10 canopy. He says, "I can still do gigs outside a ski resort or rent a booth in a flea market, but only during the weekend. This has been a pretty disparaging, experience so far. I don't know of any other food cart that operates during the Edmonton winter. What would you advise me to do? Keep on and get my cart and business license, or wait for the spring to come? I'm hugely thankful." Well, thank you again, Nome. You offer some great ones, and I understand it can be disparaging. You think about all the negatives, and I could give you a blue million different businesses you could just name a business, and I can guarantee you, even if I'm not qualified or experienced with a business, I can come up with a million negatives that would make you second guess your decision. Now, obviously, I'm biased. I believe and I know it works, and I've got thousands of customers that can prove that it works, along with myself, that you can work year round in the business. You know, yes, a lot of the activities change, and a lot less activities in the winter that are outdoors type activities. But a lot of people want to be outdoors. There's still jobs going outdoors. There's still construction jobs. There's still things happening outdoors. There's still people traveling that have to get to and from work. There's still people that would come and see you. You could start a business around that. There was a vendor a while back, Hot Dog Mikey, broke a world record. We've had him on the show several times, a great friend of mine. And he had, he was in a town, not the cold nature of it, but he was limited where he was set up, and he built a following on Facebook and gave out samples, and pretty soon he was a roaring success selling out daily. There's always opportunities in any town. I would care less. In fact, I would be more inclined to do it, being, as you say, there's no other people in Edmonton doing it during the winter. The winter wouldn't stop me. The only thing that I would advise is if you aren't sure of yourself, as far as you don't want to face the winter, and you have the benefit of not having to, then don't. But most of us, it's a great time because we can get our feet under us. We can start the business then. We can get prepared. We can start working some events and get some experience under our belt, so that then by the time the spring hits, we've already got a feel, a layout of the land, so to speak. Yes, it's going to be cold. Yes, that stuff happens. But you talking about the huge vendor in Alaska that vends through all year. So it doesn't really matter. Yeah, you could get an enclosed trailer. That helps out a ton, but it's a lot more money and you're limited where you can put it. Kind of like a 10 by 10 tent is limited, but a cart's easier to put places. So I hope that helps. And please go to the blog and type in winter, and you'll see a lot of different articles we've done on winter working. But great questions. I appreciate you sharing that question with everyone. And I wish you well. Please keep us up to date. And I'll see you every first Sunday of the month live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV. Thanks for joining us.